Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play 999. 9 hours, 9 persons, $9. With me, TapersCrazy, where I last left off, we made about making our escape from this room, and we're still on with that, but it seems to be constantly slowing the game down for all this information given about this mysterious Alice person and other such things like morphogenetic fields or whatever they're called. So let's just continue our conversation with Ace about freezing things without the water particles free crystallizing. Space travel? Are you serious? Surely you've heard of suspended animation. Cryogenic freezing? It's a fairly common idea in science fiction books and films. People are sometimes frozen for especially lengthy journeys through space. That was when Junpei understood what Ace was suggesting. Whoa, wait a minute there. Ace looked at him and raised an eyebrow. Are you saying that Alice was frozen using that CES thing? Well, I'm sure the possibility is quite low, but it is a possibility. If this special ice you call Ice 9 does indeed exist, and if CES were used to freeze her into that sort of ice instantaneously, you think she could be alive? Well, I can't say for sure, of course. What are you talking about possibilities? The melting point for Ice 9 is 96 degrees, right? If she were put somewhere where she could reach that temperature... That's nuts! Are you really saying she could have defrosted and started walking about? You're quite right. Does sound unbelievable. But if she had, then we would have an explanation for the man we found dead on the floor.
You mean the guy just like a captain? Why would we have an explanation exactly? We're assuming that Alice has been frozen since the ancient Egypt times. Are we not?
Yes. He was dead when we found him. Clearly he was murdered. But if he was murdered, then by who? Couldn't have been one of us. It would be impossible. In order to enter the captain's quarters, one must first open door one. That door requires the Earth key. Prevented us from accessing door one. Who was it that opened that door?
Santa and Lotus.
Right. Clearly the two of them could not have opened door one. Or any other door for that matter. Who else then could have done so?
Junpei thought for a second.
Nobody.
After Santa and Lotus had used the Earth key, they turned back and met up with Junpei and June, who had just returned from EDEC. The four of them proceeded to return to the large hospital room to reunite with Ace, Seven, and Clover. When Junpei and his team had gone into the shower room, Ace, Seven, and Clover had been left in the large hospital room, but they would have been unable to open door one. Perhaps when Junpei and June had taken the elevator to door two then? No. That would have been impossible. If they'd been gone only 5 minutes, no human being could have run to the captain's quarters, killed the man in there, and run back in 5 minutes.
It would be impossible for any of us to be the murderer. That being the case, who could have killed him? Won't it make sense if his killer was someone who had been in the ship for some time? A person like that would know the ship well. They would know the locations of all the hidden passages and secret doors. If a number of doors would mean nothing to someone like that, it would be a simple thing for him to enter the captain's quarters.
Then you're saying the killer was Alice. It was Junpei's turn to raise an eyebrow. Ace drew his thumb across his lips thoughtfully.
Well, this is all only one possible theory.
All ice. Alice. Was Alice indeed somewhere on the ship with them? Junpei had only one clue. The key card in his hand. It would, he hoped, grant him access to the Forest of Knowledge. But beyond that, what waited for him beyond the Forest of Knowledge? Whatever might be there, however, would have to wait. At the moment, there was nothing Junpei could do. He gripped the keycard tighter and shoved it deep into his pocket. Okay. I assume I need to read that. Anyway, we got this file. About a medical record, nautical table, information about Alice. Search. A file found in Spinal Hair Glitch Mission Egypt. Okay. Right. So now what do we do? We still need to get through this thing. There's a button on it. Nothing happens when I push it. Huh. Okay. Well, I'm at a loss then. Unless I need to use a Morse code thing for something else. Oh, yes, this thing. Unique key. Right. Pay attention to what's going on around you, tapers. It'll save you a lot of time in future. Right. The exit. It's locked. This thing. The control panel for the electronic lock. Looks like it's got a keyhole on the bottom. Bottom right. Maybe the key I got earlier. Sweet. Just had to put that key in. And now it's on.
Jumper, look. There's a minus sign on the screen.
There's 8 of them. That probably means we've got to put in 8 digits.
Do you think you can figure it out?
8 digits, huh? So I put in the 8 digit number, I just press E to enter it. If I mess up, I guess I just press C. Let's give it a shot. Okay, no, I don't think that's going to work. Huh, what's the passcode? I'm pretty sure I've searched every part of this room by now. Item. Is it something to do with this? Am I supposed to know what this means in Morse code? 1, 2, 3. No, don't think that's going to mean anything. I don't know. Once I put in my 8-digit number, I just need to enter it. If I miss up, I guess I just press C. One more time. Huh, what's the passcode? I'm pretty sure I'm searching part of his room by now. No, okay. Shit! Wrong again?
Hey, Junpei! Did you find a list of numbers and letters? I think that might be a clue.
Huh? A list of numbers and letters? Did I? Oh, I did indeed! I don't think I've used this yet. Numerical systems chart. But that doesn't make any sense. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. UBCEF. Okay, search. Numerical system chart found in the captain's quarters. 10 in base 10 is written as A in hexadecimal. Therefore, 11 is B, 12 is C, 13 is D, 14 is E, and so on. Chart show rules for each numerical system. 14 is E. Okay. So what is it you want me to do about that? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So let me just get my pen and paper here. I'm gonna try 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. It's probably not it, like, but you know. 31. Okay. I'm just try that. That's the simplest thing that I can do right now. Right. So, got. Yes! So, jumpy. 0, 8. 15. 23, 31. No. Okay. Damn it! Why isn't this working?
Hey, Jumpy! Look at the letters on the monitor! I think that's weird!
Dial them! Okay, so Z would be all the way up to... file... Z. Neural system chart found 10 in base 10 is written as A in hex decimal, therefore 11 is B, 14 is E. I assume that this goes on forever. C, E. What would Z be then? Okay, let me just get my pen and paper. I'll work this out off camera quickly. Okay, once more from the top. Okay. This might be wrong, but we'll just see how it goes. Z is 35. E is 14, R is 27, and 0 is 24. Hey! There we go! I'm a genius! It worked!
Good job, Junpei!
Yes! Excellent! You seem to have unlocked it! Good work, Junpei! Alright, let's go! But what's the camera got to do with anything, then? Let's get out of this place.
You found it! Now continue on with learning about ice and stuff.
They stepped out of the captain's quarters and into another hallway. The hallway stretched out in front of Junpei for a bit, before turning left like a great backward L. Junpei rounded the corner and took off down the straightaway. He ran, and ran, and ran. At the end of the hallway was a door. He made straight for it. He was nearly halfway through when he noticed a piece of paper in the middle of the floor. What was the piece of paper doing in the middle of the hallway? Junpei skidded to a halt. He dropped down to his hands and knees and quickly tore the paper off of the floor. A map, okay. Now they had a chance to examine it more closely. Was clear that it was a map. More specifically, a map of the ship's interior for the A deck. Perfect.
What's wrong?
A slightly slower by virtue of his advanced age, I finally caught up to Junpei. Junpei said nothing, simply showed Ace what he had found. He looked at it long enough to determine what it was, and nodded.
I see.
With that, he began running again, past Junpei.
Later, nerd!
Junpei shoved the map into his pocket and got up to follow Ace, but something stopped him.
Hey!
Oh, hey, where's Clover? He turned around. Clover was nowhere to be seen. Damn it, what the hell is she up to? Junpei muttered angrily under his breath and took off back the way he came. As he stomped around the corner, he saw her. She was standing in front of the door to the captain's quarter, her hand on the doorknob. As Junpei watched, she closed it gently and quietly. What the hell are you doing?
Nothing.
Do you mean nothing? Clover had unconsciously put her hands over pockets of her jacket, as if trying to hide something. What the hell is that?
What?
You put something in your pocket. What is it?
Oh, fish. Fishes. A note.
A note?
Yeah. I found it in the pocket of a guy with a captain's clothes. It said something about the darkness of his sinister hand or something.
What the hell? Let me see it. But Junpei wasn't going to get to see it. From the other end of the hall, he heard Ace's voice.
Hey, Junpei! Clover! What are you two doing? Hurry up!
Clover shrugged.
I'll show it to you later, alright? Come on, we gotta hurry!
Before Junpei could protest, she was gone. Around the corner and off down the long stem of the L. A note. A note. Junpei was curious, but there was something else that bothered him. Her pocket had been bulging, far more than it would from just a note. Junpei did his best to convince himself that it would make sense later and ran off after Clover. What's she hiding? Junpei pushed through the door and found himself in a large room with a large set of stairs. Aww. It was just what he'd expected to see after reading the map. His "I see" after reading the map himself meant that Ace had probably realized the same thing. Junpei looked around, but Ace was nowhere to be seen. He put his hand on the handrail and leaned over to look down. There he was. Not just Ace, Santa June 7 and Lotus as well. Junpei and Clover glanced at each other and hurried down the stairs. They reached B-deck at the same time.
Junpei! Clover!
June's face was excited. Something had happened. Miss Junpei could tell by simply looking at her. What's up? Given their situation, he was not inclined to be excited about sudden developments. June, however, couldn't contain herself.
We found it!
Found what?
We found it!
What did you find?
The last door! We found door 9!
What?
Come on, just follow us! We'll explain on the way!
Okay, let's go. Seven turned and jogged off down the stairs. The rest followed.
We finally made it!
Relief and excitement in her voice echoed what each one of them felt. Yeah, it's finally time. Junpei wasn't quite ready to believe they'd really done it. At least not just yet. Still, if everyone said that it was door 9, then it probably was. He could feel his heart racing. A mixture of anticipation and fear ran through his veins. And he could feel his legs shaking. He was doing his best to maintain a sense of healthy skepticism. But he couldn't deny that the prospect of escape was an exciting one. But there was one thing he couldn't get off his mind. The numbered door could only accommodate between 3 and 5 people. There were 7 of them on the way to door 9. That meant that even in the best case scenario, there would be 2 of them who would have to stay behind. 2 people. He didn't have any solutions to that problem yet, but he was desperately hoping one would present itself. Junpei looked over at the clock. The hands indicated that it was 4:30. They had 90 minutes before their time was up.
Hey, Junpei! June! What the hell are you doing? Hurry it up!
Santa's voice jolted Junpei out of his reverie.
Let's go, Junpei!
June took off down the stairs, jogging as quickly as she could. Junpei followed. Okay. Down the elevator then. Terrifying freaking elevator, it looks like a freaking isolation cell. As a group, they piled onto the elevator and rode impatiently down to E-deck. It looked familiar. There was a metal grate between the 2 elevators. 7 grabbed hold of it and began to talk.
I know I told you I'd explain it earlier, but honestly there ain't much to explain. Please put it off from you guys, the 4 of us got onto the elevator on the left. I took us to the side of the grate. After that,
they headed down another hallway, took them toward the bow of a ship, and eventually to the number 6 that Junpei and June had found earlier. With 4, they'd been able to open the door and keep going. As usual, they faced a locked door but had been forced to complete 2 different areas before they could unlock it. Once they were through that door, there was another hallway that went in the other direction towards the stern. So, on your way you found the elevator.
That's right!
So in other words, you kinda did a lap, huh? You came from that side to this side.
Yeah.
With that settled, Junpei looked around. So, where's the number 9 door?
Over here! Follow me!
7 began walking down the hallway that led toward the stern. Junpei and the others broke into a jog to keep up with him. God, it must be huge then. They'd been walking for a while. June in silence stepped with Junpei when she spoke.
You know, it's because of Santa that we're all here right now.
Huh?
And all 7 of us are going to door 9. You don't get it. Santa's 7 and Lotus. What's their digital route?
3 plus 7 plus 8 equals 18. 1 plus 8 equals 9. 9. It's 9.
That's right. They could have just left me behind and kept going if they wanted to.
But they didn't.
Yes, because Santa wouldn't let them. He said we can't leave June behind. So I went looking for you guys.
Aw, that's nice. Anyway, we'll continue this in the next episode because I'm out of time for this one. So thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe if you're on YouTube. Upvote, comment, follow if you're on VidMe.
and I'll see you all in the next video.